What? No, no, that's okay. Am I audible, guys?
Yes.
Okay. No, no, that's okay. What, according to you, is the total budget that will be required for us to get Mahadevapura to the vision you had for 2024-32, which you talked about when you visited last time? Because until now, we don't know the detailed plan that we have and the budget required to make Mahadevapura a green constituency.
More than 1 lakh crore.
But do we have a blueprint against it, is the question we have.
I have a blueprint.
Okay.
That's why I'm telling more than a crore, 1 lakh crore.
But is it published, sir?
No.
So don't you think, sir, we as resident welfare associations can contribute in that?
Yeah, you can. Because it is a blueprint.
Yeah.
So you can contribute it. Whatever the, we have to make the prioritize the issues.
Correct.
I have a blueprint, but I am not confident of getting all 1 lakh crore in a 5 years.
Okay.
It should be divided.
Correct.
That's why we need to make a priority.
Correct.
This is the first priority, this one is the second priority. If I am getting more money from Modi government also, this can be included. This, we need to make the priorities.
But in the last 3 years, Modi government has given more money as per your manifesto.
Yes.
So then where is it?
Unfortunately, it is touched up or else misused in this government. Because one example I can quote, he has sent the money for building houses for
Avas
Yojana. Nothing has been done, nothing progress has been done in that. I started a house, building houses in the Ado Siddhartha, near his house, on the way towards Kodti. Kodti. For that is BSY scheme, our government has started. That is for houses for drivers, auto drivers, tempo drivers, housemates. So for them, low cost house. Apart from that, we have built the houses for BPL families. It has also stopped in between. So that money has not used there. If they could have used properly, these 2-3 projects can be completed within a year after the Modi government coming into central.
Okay.
Such example, lot of examples are there.
No, sir, there is a scheme called Amrut, which is Atal Mission for Rejuvenation and Urban Transformation. The funding is not enough for our state government.
Unfortunately, myself and PC Mohan went to BDA, went to BBMP and asked them to send a DPR, detailed project report, to Union government. The engineers and the chairman and MD of the BDA, he has sent it to environment department. Again and again we said, send it to Venkayanadu. Venkayanadu was the minister that time. They have sent it to environment minister. Again it came back. He only quoted Venkayanadu in meetings, he said, in Bangalore, send the proposal in Amruta Yojana to me. That is urban development ministry.
Because without that, how will we get the funding, sir?
That's why I am telling you, they have not sent the proposal itself from the state government. You know how the federal governments will work. This is a federal system. The government of Karnataka has to send the proposal to the union government. And money will come to union, through union government for other ones also through state government. It will not directly come to the...
Correct.
For the... except railway or such projects which are controlled by the union government.
Sir, the next question is footpath hoarding. We have been doing BBMP drives and whatnot around this area and it's an eternal problem across Bangalore. It is not very specific to Mahadevapura. But what is your solution for it, sir? Because the hoarding has been so bad, every day we are suffering because of that.
We have to implement like Mysore. Nobody can put flags or banners or anything in the Mysore. It is a trial basis of Swachh Bharat and that act should come into Bangalore.
But here the problem is even the construction is going into footpath, right?
No.
There are certain constructions which go all the way into footpath. We see basically stairs, what not coming onto the footpath, right? Chai walas and everyone is there on the footpath. Why is that we can't implement it?
You ask about the holdings.
No, I'm just telling, not just holdings, I'm just saying footpath encroachment has
to be. Encroachment has to be clear every monthly. Otherwise, what will happen? This month I will take, I will force. They have to fix up a date. As I started Swachh Bharat, every first Sunday of the month, I used to go for Swachh Bharat. Like that, we have to make a rule for BBMP officers, go for footpath encroachers on every specific day of a month. Then only again and again they will come.
But even with Swachh Bharat, the same problem.
Put an example.
They will go into, again in 5 minutes they will come back. They are fine, they will not come back.
There should be fine, and also there should be a space where they can keep their shop. These all, and who should, I tried in the first regime at ITPL area. We have designed the chariot also. How the this chariot should be. They will put on the roadside. No. This is the design. What they asked is, sir, you are MLA, you make it and give us. Like that they asked me, whatever it may be. Till that way, we went to create the such facilities. It went for 3 months. Again, it has gone. This is a routine work of the officers, bureaucrats. They have to go on the road and clear it.
Which comes to the important question.
And we will make the rules for them.
BBMP trifurcation, what is your stand on that, sir?
I am against it. Trifurcation is not the solution. Administration decentralization is needed.
But
let me answer now. What is my party stand? Say for example, Karnataka Assembly is one. For entire Karnataka, 224 MLAs are sitting in assembly. Like that for entire Bangalore, 199 corporators has to sit one side. Administration should be decentralized. And there should be 5 commissioners for Bangalore. Then only it can be, work can be done.
Okay, but last 5 years we haven't seen, previous to that also, nothing has progressed.
Nothing has progressed because of this government. And there is a pending in the, this act is pending in president, with the president of India. And BJP will bring, yesterday our manifesto has released, Nava Bangalore Act will be brought to the, for Bangalore, which is pending with the president of India. And in that, some associations of my area only, they have suggested some amendments. With that amendments, we will implement the new KPT Act for Bangalore.
Okay.
Now Bangalore Act is working on Karnataka Municipal Act.
Correct.
Which is for, even for a Haveri municipality is also same, Bangalore municipality is also same. Bangalore needs more powerful powers and amendments for this act. That will bring.
Okay. And one question which came from most of them was again pollution. The pollution has reached maximum level, at least in Mahadevapura here. One is due to construction, another is due to lot of traffic. And the green cover is very less. Even if you walk through or drive through this area, there is no green cover and there is no clear initiative in terms of green cover. What is your solution for that, sir?
So first you should understand this is a developing area. Not only Mahadevapura, outer Bangalore is developing area. So we need more facilities. Say for example, Kaveri pipeline is coming, UCD is coming, and gas pipeline is coming. And also, unfortunately or fortunately, Kolar pipeline is going from Bellandur to Kolar. Lot of development, such development activity is going on. Because of that, the dust and everything is there. Apart from that, as you rightly said, so the construction on the, with construction going on the site, they will dump the their materials on the roadside. These things are also there.
and I have stopped new city. Why? Because it is unscientific. You have said about the green area. There is no provision of such green areas. Why? Because the land value in this area is off. That's why unscientifically they have made the CDP, and I had a press conference with the presentation, PPT presentation, and I have shown it to Chief Minister also, where he has called the meeting, and after that they have constituted a committee to go through all the grievances, and they wanted to avoid the grievances, the in charge Minister of Bangalore. And again I intervened with the Chief Minister. Chief Minister has made a committee now. Fortunately, that is not implemented. Say for example, there is a road coming on a Vartur temple. This side here, the CDP is showing this NGT order, buffer zone. Other side they are showing the road. And they are showing the green area where the build already houses are built, buildings are there. They are showing that one as a green area. Again, it leads to corruption. Why? Because the building owners will rush to the BD officers. They will bribe them and they will change the zone. This thing was going on, and I successfully stopped it. Such issues we need to discuss. And I can say the illegal buildings are more in this entire outer area. The officer will sit in the BBMP office, he will give permission without inspection, and after the construction also he will issue the LOC without certificate. The private companies, private agencies, the architects will give the certificates, on that basis they will issue the LOC. So first thing is I need to stop entire illegal things till it should legalize with the proper rules and regulations. Whatever the existing rules are there, they have to follow it. If they are not followed, we have to verify all these buildings. Till then, no construction in this area.
But is that happening on the ground,
sir? No. I am telling after the election time. I am telling about when the government, our government is coming in, that time I want to implement this for Bangalore, at least for my area. You have seen, you have experienced this same road, the building was collapsed.
Correct.
And another building was collapsed in near Bellathur. So such activities are going on because of greedy. People are very greedy. Why? Because they will get more rent. The permission will be for 2 floors. They will go up to 4th floor or 5th floor without illegally they are constructing. And they are not putting a proper foundation also. Because of that, buildings are collapsing. So such incidents should not happen. In coming days, we need to stop all the buildings and we need to verify. Like combing of the operation. We need to combing of the operation, like the police have done at a Naxalite area that is called combing. We need to do BBMP constructions, combing of this entire Bangalore, outer Bangalore, whatever the buildings are there, legal or illegal, and what they have done. About the construction also, quality of the construction, we need to verify.
So the lake issue, sir, we have Junasandra, which is there, Junasandra Lake, which is in legal tangles, and there is also the Kasavanahalli Lake, which still needs to get developed and access to our Kasavanahalli Road. It is said as Kasavanahalli Lake, but it is not accessible for anyone. Neither we have any green cover around it, right? I mean, we don't have any green cover here, parks, playgrounds, nothing. So how can you help us in this area, sir? Because you have already been here for 10 years and you could have done something for us on that front. Why couldn't it happen?
Whatever is done, which is from my side only, please understand, because I am not telling any lie. If you go my first book, it is recorded there 5 years before. And now also it is recorded. Whatever I have done, in Chowdhury. We have shifted the houses who are living there and built the houses for them and shifted to Varthur and we developed the lake. And even Taikondalandi, even Kasavanahalli, Harlu Lake, whatever we have developed, that is because of our government. And whatever the left, no, I am not telling it is 100%. And whatever the left out issues are there, if road is approachable and if it is there in the record, definitely we'll make the approachable road to you, to the lake.
Okay.
It's not the issue.
And how about Junnasandra Lake, sir? What is the issue?
Same thing. Junnasandra topography is different. Because I am a civil engineer, I can understand. So, topography is different. The village is like this. And water flows, some of the water flows this side and other half of the water flows this side. There is a layout, gated communities there. They are not allowing to flow the water. Lot of these type of issues are there about the Junnasandra. And we are addressing it.
Okay. Sir, road widening, what is your stand? Kasavanahalli Main Road as well as Sarjapur Road. Now, yes. Kasavanahalli Main Road as per CDP was 80 feet road, right? That is not yet implemented. In this term, if you come back, will you promise us that this road widening will happen?
Yes, definitely.
And you were saying
that Sarjapur I am making also. Effort. See, one thing, with the dialogue, we can make the issues clear. Without, if you attempt, without dialogue, with the concerned people, they will go to the court. And it will be a long time. They will give the dates and again they will postpone the issues. It will hurdle the development. That's why whatever I did in other parts, even in this part also, I had a dialogue with the concerned people. Whatever may be the public work, then people will understand. Wherever they understood these things, sir, they have left their lands and we have made the that developmental activity. Even for lake, even for road, even for public places like park in some parts of the my constituency. So here also, for Sarjapura Road, the issue is about compensation. They are not ready for a TDR. And government is not ready for a compensation.
It is a half-hearted attempt they have.
This is the issue. And definitely I will promise here, after coming into power, after this election, we will go for a compensation for this road as a specific case, as a particular case, like we did it in Kundalini Junction. People were not ready. I had 3-4 meetings with the landowners. Again, lastly they asked for the compensation. They were not ready for the. Till now, BDA has not given a single TDR. Since from four years. This is the issue. That's why they are asking a compensation. We'll give the compensation for Sarjapura Road. And our people are working on that, convincing the landowners. And definitely we'll go for a widening with the compensation. And same thing with the Kasavanahalli Road.
Okay.
Kasavanahalli, there is an issue. At the end of this road, there is a small slum like houses are there. That will become a widening accident zone. So actually Son Shekhar Reddy and Shekhar Reddy, they convinced the, earlier they have convinced the who are living there to shift their houses from there to somewhere else. We have the land available. We have a land to build such houses for them. Again somebody has spoiled their mind. They went back. Again we will do effort and we will convince them. If not, they are going to convince, we will act on that.
Sir, actually the main problem in Kasavanahalli is our Kasavanahalli Main Road is marked as a major district road in 2008. Okay? as per CDP, it is still designated as an 18-meter road. But once it is marked as MDR, Major District Road, or Primary Urban Road, it has to be 24 meters, right? I have personally been involved in several transactions of illegal constructions happening on the margin land, where I have approached BBMP, I have approached BDA, I have approached Town Planning Authority, right? I go to BBMP saying, why are you allowing the margin land construction? They say, sir, this is not approved by us, this is approved by Town Planning Authority. I go to Town Planning Authority saying,
what is your bottom line?
So bottom line is, there are three groups within the governance who is approving illegal constructions on our road, right? And they are just passing the buck from one department to the other, saying, as per CDP it is 18 meter, I approved. The other guy says, no, I did not approve, it is some other department that approved. We as citizens who are fighting all these illegal causes, we don't have a single point of connect to go approach and express our grievances.
No, they have misguided you. There is no only one agency. Other agency will give the NOC. The approval authorities be BBMP. BBMP has to approve major roads department.
They don't accept. I'm telling you,
they are misguiding you.
Exactly, that's what I'm trying to say. So my question is this. Can we do something once you come into power?
Please, for such issues, please approach my officer to me. Or else Suresh Ashash.
No, Mr. Suresh knows all the cases
I'm telling you now. We have resolved a lot of issues, such issues.
No, sir. My question is a little different. So I'm asking the question, can we do something from a legislative angle such that you can bring citizens or empower citizens so that they can raise concerns and those concerns can be addressed because citizens do
what
not
approve. Example you have quoted, it is not needed.
Okay.
Act is there. You please approach my office. I will call a meeting of the officers, concerned officers. If they are saying three agencies, I will call all the three agencies. I will clear the issue. For other thing, what you have suggested, say for example, lake. Recently they have amended it. For that, I want to bring an amendment. Lakes have been brought in a one umbrella now. It is under minor irrigation department now. It's good. For the development sake, they are keeping citizens aloof from the development. That we have opposed. Definitely we will bring the amendment for that. Because they are maintaining our lakes. There is an association here. In all the places, they are maintaining it. The government, present government, don't want to maintain those things. By the activists, lake activists or citizens, that we need to bring an amendment. Even they are investing, it should be a PPP model. Government has to give money, his share, and public has to, private people has to give a share also. Now, the thing is, they are not allowing the private persons to develop the lakes, private companies. That we have to bring the amendment. In such cases, definitely we need a citizen support involvement.
Not just in lakes alone, sir. What my question
is. I quoted
an
example.
I understand. So my question is, in everything else also, can we start bringing citizens and empowering
them? No, for that, there is already a ward committee. We need to give a more power to the ward committee.
Thank you.
Sir, that is the next question.
In fact, that exactly. Thanks for bringing that up. That's where
we have a non-functional ward committee.
That's why I said, the Nava Bengaluru Act, it should include this. We are bringing amendment for that.
Okay.
But even today,
we have power the ward committee.
Today also we have ward committees, right?
There is no power for the ward committee. No. It is like a suggestive committee.
Correct.
We give more power to the ward committee.
But since you have your own corporator yourself there,
act
why can't you empower
it? Act is like that. Orally they are doing it. I have a good relation with you. I can say. What's your good name?
Vishnu.
Vishnu, go and see this work on behalf of me. If anybody is objecting, I can call. He is my representative, allow him to work. This can be done now. If I can bring a ward committee amendment for that, it will be automatically for entire Bengal.
Okay. So next question is more around STP and DWCC, right? I mean, we are having a lot of issues on this front, at least in across Bangalore, but definitely in Mahadevapura. Forget about collections also. There is no segregation points. There is no scientific approach. Just behind this building also, we see some of the dumpings happening right now. Right? What is your solution for it, sir?
Only solution I have experienced since from 10 years. I have agitated against this in the government when our government was there and outside the government when our government was not there. Only solution is we have to give a contract to the companies directly.
Okay.
Lot of companies are ready. I have thought of putting a processing unit at a ward level.
Okay.
This is a big ward. In other wards, with two wards, we can put a processing unit there itself. With a, what they are demanding, one is garbage.
Correct.
Second is land. Land is not allotted to them. They are ready to come here. And they are ready to collect your garbage from your house and taking it to their processing unit on their own cost. And they are ready to pay to BBMP.
But
problem is with the bureaucracy and in charge minister. What I experienced about this, he only suggested. And I searched the land. There is a land here also in his ward. They have not given the permission to such companies.
But sir, can you assure us that if you as BJP come to power, you will take this down the highest priority? Because Bangalore really stinks. No matter who says what, I take pride in Bangalore. But then we need to be open about the fact Bangalore stinks, right? That's the reason we are asking.
This is my dream project. Why? Because they have stopped dumping garbage at Bandur. It is part of my constituency after my agitation. And again they started dumping at Mitiganalli. Again they stopped after my agitation. They were dumping in a quarry, unscientifically. Technically they have stopped because the quarry belongs to two constituencies. One is Mahadevapura, that is my constituency. Half of the quarry comes to my constituency, survey number wise. Half of the survey numbers will go to Patrayanpura, where the minister, agriculture minister, is a MLA from that area, he is allowing to dump the garbage there. Unfortunately, the smell and leachate is coming to my constituency, to Kandur Lake. And smell is coming as per the direction of the wind. So, it is unscientific way of doing it. So definitely, I have got some experience about this. I want to implement, starting from my constituency itself.
Okay.
Definitely I will do it.
Sir, next question is around the corruption aspect of it. One of the breakthrough programs that was there, at least in the Indian administrative reforms, is SAKAALA, which happened to be from your government only. But now you have brushed it completely under the dustbin, right? I mean, even now, if we go, there is no implementation on the ground. In fact, as per the latest statistics, 77% of Karnataka experiences corruption when they reach government works. Why is that not implementable, at least in this constituency? Forget about where you have your own corporator.
SAKAALA is stopped by this government, not by MLA.
It is not yet stopped, no, sir. It is still
stopped. Almost stopped.
But we need that because without
and
that
Loka
we
Loka has been defunct now. Because of ACP and ACP is headed by the Chief Minister. This all such agencies they have ruined, and unfortunately such transparency is not there in this government. We need to bring back SAKAALA as well as you want to give more power to Lokayukta instead of ACP. Because of that he is not under any carpet.
Correct. So, because the latest statistics says 96% of grievance from public is not getting addressed, which was almost 20 million applications were being processed in 2012-13 without any intervention.
That's why
today 96% is not working on the ground.
That's why Prime Minister said in first meeting, I was there with him, I am in charge for all the three programs. In first meeting in Bangalore, he said 10% government without paying 10%. it will not work in Karnataka. People have wrote to him, mailed him. He said in Mysore, it is not 10%. Karnataka people have wrote to me and called me and mailed me saying that it is a 30% government. In Davangere, he said, again, Sida Rupiah government. This is the situation of this government. I said, no, 2,43,000 rupees has been sent by Modi government to Karnataka. And Amit Shahji is asking an account. I have given my account. Since 1-5 years, what I did, though it is a discrimination, in my government I got 1,400 crores. In this government I fought with them and I got only 798 crores. And you have not asked me the account. This is my responsibility. As a being a MLA of this area, I have given my account to the voters. You voted me or not, but it is my duty. And what Chief Minister is saying, after who are you to ask this? This is his answer. Isab do kis Siddaramaiah ji aisa Amit Shah ji ne pucha. Aap kaun hote hai puchne wale? Is a Rajya Sabha member? Is a president of the ruling party of the union government? This is the answer of this government.
But it's not like Karnataka is not contributing, sir. It is the GDP contribution. I was just reading last 3 years. Our contribution to the country's GDP has doubled, right? The fiscal deficit has remained 2.8% from the last 5 years from Siddaramaiah ji. Now, that means you are almost doubled your revenue, but nothing is visible on the ground. So one of the accusations made is, no, Mr. Limbavalli sir hasn't approached the CM for the funds for Mahadevapura.
I can print my all the letters. I can, if you go through my Facebook of 5 years, you will be seeing my photos with the Chief Minister, with the ministers, and letters also. And several times, in the meeting only I raised here, you have to reserve at least 25% of my revenue, which is collecting from my area, should be utilized for the local area. That's why I demanded decentralization of the administration. We need a commissioner here. Then the revenue will be collected here. Whichever the revenue is collected here can be spent here. Demanded that in front of the Chief Minister. So please reserve 25% of my revenue to my development of this constituency.
Sir, as a corollary to that, I believe there is an option, legal option available, where you can file a writ petition stating a percentage of your tax collection can be withheld from the citizen's side and can be reutilized for the development of the locality.